Hi, my name is Amar Sapra and I am Associate Professor at IIM Bangalore. I completed my PhD in 2004 at Cornell University in Supply Chain Management. Prior to joining IIM Bangalore in 2009, I taught at the University of Florida and Cornell University in the US. I work in the field of supply chain management, pricing and inventory control. As far as teaching is concerned, I've taught courses on inventory control, spreadsheet analytics, Monte Carlo simulation, and optimization. Supermarkets and retail stores all over the world have to throw away perishable items because they are not able to sell them before the items expire. So as an example, a study done in the US in 2007 estimated that the top 40 US retailers were throwing away as much as 500 million pounds of foods every year due to spoilage. Spoilage is not restricted only to foods or consumer goods. Some of the industrial goods could also be perishable. So obviously, spoilage is a loss. A spoiled item becomes worthless or nearly worthless. So if in some way the spoilage could be reduced, it could make a direct impact on the bottom line of a firm. One possibility, one solution to reduce spoilage is to manage demand through modulation of prices. So let's see how this will work. In Indian context, several supermarkets sell packaged eggs that have a shelf life of 15 to 30 days. So let's say a supermarket discovers that it has plenty of boxes of eggs that are unsold and that have, let's say, only 5 to 7 days of life remaining. So what it could do is it could offer significant discounts on those eggs, and in that way it could incentivize those customers who have an immediate need for eggs to purchase them, and the eggs are off the shelf. But this is easier said than done. One of the problems with the execution of this strategy would be to determine the right amount of discount to give. If the price discount that has been given is very high, then that would affect the profit margin for the supermarket. On the other hand, if discount is not high enough, it may make very little impact on the demand, and therefore the spoilage reduction will not be significant enough. So with this motivation, I and a PhD student recently completed a project in which we sought to determine the optimal amount of fresh inventory to order as well as the optimal price to set. So just to give an idea of the kind of work we do, I would list three sample results that we have obtained as part of this study. Number one, we showed that the shape of the profit as a function of decision variables is nice, which enables easy computation of the optimal order quantity as well as price. Number two, we showed a result which is kind of intuitive in the sense that we proved that as the amount of old inventory increases, the amount of fresh inventory to be ordered as well as the price to be set both decrease. And number three, we derived formulas for order quantity and price that are simple and easy to use in the sense that they can be used by a manager in a spreadsheet. The good thing about these formulas is that they give near optimal profit. A far more effective strategy would be to sell old units maybe at a discount and fresh units at MRP. The reason this is important is because every time customers see new and old units sold at the same price, they tend to pick fresh units over old units. Now, when the supermarket or a firm is setting differential kind of prices for fresh and old units, in a way it's creating two different market segments. One segment corresponds to those customers that want only fresh units but are willing to pay a higher price. On the other hand, the second segment would correspond to those customers that are price sensitive and have an immediate need for the product. So those customers would take up the old units knowing that they will be able to consume the units before they expire, and in turn they also save some money on the price. So with this in mind, we have now extended our previous project to have differential prices for old and fresh units. The other decision variable regarding the amount of order quantity still remains in the model. This new model is considerably more difficult to analyze. And one of the things, for example, we have found is that the nice shape of the profit with respect to decision variables no longer holds. So it's a lot more difficult now to determine optimal order quantity as well as optimal prices compared to the previous model. As a result, we have now focused our attention on deriving formulas for price as well as prices as well as order quantity that give near optimal profit. We hope that with the completion of this study, managers in supermarkets and other retail stores will have a tool in hand that they can use to improve their bottom line.